At the same time, given the pressures of society and social media, women, of course, still want to look and feel their best. But that comes with a price, too. We put a poll up on our social media today asking you if you had to get rid of one of these things, manicures, makeup, or trips to the hair salon, which would you choose? The overwhelming majority chose nails. 13% said makeup, and nobody voted for hair in this case. We found out, even with the rising price of beauty, salons are busier than ever. But there is one big expense women are happy to hunt for a bargain.
You did amazing.
Oh, thank you.
We do a lot of extensions.
You can do one row for volume. There's tape-in extensions. This is the sew-in weft extension.
It costs a lot of money and it's an expensive service.
Expensive service that people are still willing to pay for.
Absolutely.
For many women, money well spent is spent at the salon. After all, beauty knows no boundaries.
I feel like you get what you pay for no matter what.
In each seat inside Fiore and Ella Beauty Bar and Salon, you'll find a woman.
Most of our guests are women with color and extension services.
Getting work done on her hair.
That's our specialty. That's what we're good at.
Pamela Gibson owns the salon.
Why, thank you, darling.
Where happy clients are essential for business. But running the business is getting more expensive.
And we didn't want to raise our prices, but everything has just gone up, so we had to. We had no choice.
As it turns out, women are willing to pay a pretty penny for pretty hair.
10 more minutes, okay.
From a $50 haircut to a $100 highlight.
Why aren't women skimping on beauty?
I think, in my opinion, that they maybe skimp in another area because it's important to feel good about yourself. People want to look good and feel good.
Pamela's right. Women may not be bargain hunting at the hair salon, but they can't overlook a good deal on a designer dress.
Usually there aren't good deals on manicures and getting your hair done. So when you can come to a place to get better deals on the price of clothing, it's a good option.
Karen Grain is a first-time shopper at True Fashionistas in Naples, a consignment store full of the brands women know and love.
I love that there's Lilly Pulitzer, and you can pay about 20%, 25% of what the dress originally costs.
From what we could tell, she was having a great time.
It's really fun because I'm one that likes to try all different clothes, and I get tired of them very quickly.
Store owner Jennifer Johnson has heard that one before.
Women do change their mind an awful lot, and men do too.
And when they do, they bring their gently used items to places like this.
We only wear 20% of what we have in our closet. So that tells you, we go out and we buy things because, oh, on a whim, we were on vacation, or we walked into the store and this person said, oh gosh, that looks so great on you. And we buy it, and then it sits in our closet and we never wear it.
But with retail prices rising, women are turning toward resale.
True Fashionistas is super popular right now because, number one, the resale industry is just on fire.
Most of the stuff is like brand new with tags still on them.
Stacey Camacho works at the store.
The prices in the stores are ridiculous, and you could get them for like half the price.
She leads the women right to the racks they're looking for.
The women like coming here, they get a bargain, and like with today's prices, you feel like you came out a winner.
Resale isn't just affordable. Jennifer points out it's also good for the planet.
And consumers are embracing it because it is sustainable. It is helping the earth, it's helping them save money, and it's all in one fell swoop.
And a good deal looks good on anyone.
Because when you look good and feel good, your whole personality shines.
That is so true. And if you're thinking about skipping the salon and doing your own hair, coloring it yourself to save some money, here's a word of caution from the professionals.
Don't do that. First of all, the products are not quality. Second of all, we go through a lot of training and we have to learn the chemistry behind it. And so when someone comes to us and they say, oh, well, I tried to lighten my hair at home or whatever, we have this huge mess. It's twice as expensive. Your hair is already damaged. Takes twice as long. So it's just, that's a really big deal for us.
I concur. It can be a big disaster. Gibson says a color correction could end up costing you 2 to 3 times the service you were trying to skimp on in the first place.
Something interesting to point out. Jennifer Johnson from True Fashionistas says the clothing styles from 40 years ago, we're talking early 80s, which was the last time inflation was this high, are very similar to today's styles. Neon colors, puffy shoulders, florals, crop tops. A lot of those styles from back then are in again.